One verse they say, right? So they just sing that a bunch of times in like a temporary peace we long to. And that's it.
Yeah.
Forgiveness
is the garden of our courage.
But we're not courageous.
I think the power to grow, the peace we long to know, something like that. And I didn't think of it until we had
set
this.
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay. Shabbat shalom, everybody. We are operating a little bit on Jewish standard time, but it's okay. It's beautiful that we can be here to celebrate Shabbat. We've got our social action Shabbat. If you'll notice the floral arrangement up front, and I can say that because there is flower up there. Just throwing that out there. There are also baskets down below, and we will, in a short period, be learning more about food insecurity, something that so many of us hear about but don't understand because we've been blessed to not have to face that trauma. And yet, as a people who live prophetically, we have an obligation to make sure that we do the work. So with that, we've got two opening pieces, and I've handed out, or some Becca actually prepared and handed out, song sheets with Linda's help. And the oldie but goodie, Blowing in the Wind, Robert Zimmerman, AKA Bob Dylan, wrote, and so, you know, 50 plus years ago, we were talking about needing to stand up, to pay attention, to remember the plight of people who are in need. And that many years later, the Muse wrote the same song, different words, different music. And it's important for us to realize that despite all of the things that we've been through in the marches and everything over the last 50, 60 years, we're still facing the exact same problem. So bridging the generations, we'll start with Blowing in the Wind and then move into Invincible.
Sleeps in the sand.
Artist Pablo Picasso said, "The meaning of life is to find your gift. The purpose of life is to give it away." The late baseball and humanitarian legend Roberto Clemente taught, "If you have a chance to accomplish something that will make things better for people coming behind you, and you don't do that, you're wasting your time on earth." Peace is belief in a better world translated into the behaviors of our souls. Shalom is the byproduct of a successful partnership between God and humanity, the result of making heaven and earth touch. We're going to turn into our Siddur, our prayer book, for our candle lighting, and our Kiddush, page 120 and following. So, Gail and Patty, if you come join me.
As these Shabbat candles give light to all who behold them, so may we, by our lives, give light to all who behold us. As their brightness reminds us of the generations of Israel who have kindled light, so may we, in our own day, be among those who kindle light. Our source of light. Our source of light and truth, creator of the eternal law of goodness, help us to find knowledge by which to live. Lead us to take the words we shall speak into our hearts and our lives. Bless all who enter this sanctuary in need, all who bring the offerings of their hearts. May our worship lead us to acts of kindness, peace, and love.
And light?
Oh.
Gotta light the candles, yeah.
I know, I'm like, and
I've done this a couple. I think so. I think even since I've been here. On page 123.
The heaven and the earth were finished, and all their array. On the seventh day, God finished the work that God had been doing, and God ceased on the seventh day from all the work that God had done. And God blessed the seventh day and declared it holy, because on it God ceased from all the work of creation that God had done.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pri hagafen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav beratzav anu, b'shabbat kosho b'ahava uratzon inklilanu.
Thank you, ladies.
You're welcome.
You saved me.
Our ancestor Abraham heard God's call to leave his home and change the world. Heard God's call, and not knowing that anyone else was listening, not knowing whether or not God called anyone else, he accepted that he might be the only person who could accomplish the task. Even while our tradition reminds us that it is not any person's responsibility to finish the task of blessing the world, each of us must work as if it were, if only to set the example for the next person to step up and continue the work.
Please rise. Morit Baruch Hu. That was page 146, by the way. On page 150, in the middle, we'll read together. Everlasting joy, you offered your people Israel by teaching us Torah and mitzvot, laws and precepts. Therefore, Adonai, our God, when we lie down and when we rise up, we will meditate on your laws and your commandments. We will rejoice in your Torah forever. Day and night will we reflect on them, for they are our life, and doing them lengthens our days. Never remove your love from us. Praise to you, Adonai, who loves your people Israel. Baruch atah Adonai, Ohev Amo Yisrael. And before we continue with the words of Shema, it's important, if we're going to acknowledge that, you know, we all stand under the same, in front of the same God, same traditions from wherever we come in this world, it would be important for us to know who we're standing with. So please take just a moment and greet some folks around you. If you don't know them, this would be a great time to get to know them, okay? And if you do, reaffirm.
And you do this every Friday?
I do. One of these days I'll get it right. It's kind of like practicing. So I'll always, I will make sure I always miss occasionally.
We'll get them wrong too.
Yeah, I'll get them wrong. Okay, where did Ernie go? There he is. Okay. Yeah, I mean, we have 60 people. So, okay. So we're going to be on page 152. And the word Shema Yisrael is the command version, you shall pay attention. Or as Southern says, y'all, pay attention now. Okay? So with that, we'll continue with Shema.
Shema.
And please be seated, except for Ernie. We continue with Ve'ahavta, page 154.
V'chol levavcha u'v'chol nafshecha u'v'chol me'odecha v'hayu ha'arim ha'edah asher anochi mitzvotecha hayom al levavcha v'shinatam levavcha v'divartam v'shitecha v'beitecha Uvlechtecha v'aderet, u'shochtecha u'vkumecha, u'kshartam le'ot al yadecha, v'hayu l'totafod bein einecha, u'chtavtam al mezuzot beitecha u'visharecha, l'man tizkeru v'asitem et kol mitzvotai, V'itam kedoshim le'lohechem. Ani Adonai Elohechem. Asher hoseiti etchem me'eretz Mitzrayim li'ot lachem le'lohim. Ani Adonai Elohechem.
From Pirkei Avot. If I am not for myself, who will be for me? If I am only for myself, what good am I? If not now, when? From Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. The belief that God will do everything for people is as untenable as the belief that we can do everything for ourselves. It, too, is based in a lack of faith. We must learn that to expect God to do everything while we do nothing is not faith, but superstition. Abraham Joshua Heschel commented, "The hour calls for moral grandeur and spiritual audacity. We must feel passion for each other's dignity in the most fearless and heroic ways."
Page 160, Hashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu l'shalom, Vamidenu Shomrenu l'chaim, Ufros aleinu sukat shlomecha, V'taknenu be'etza tovam nilfanecha, V'hoshienu l'ma'an shemecha. Grant, O God, that we lie down in peace and rise up, our guardian, to life renewed. Spread over us the shelter of your peace. Guide us with your good counsel, for your namesake be our help. Shield and shelter us beneath the shadow of your wings. Defend us against enemies, illness, war, famine, and sorrow. Distance us from wrongdoing. For you, God, watch over us and deliver us. For you, God, are gracious and merciful. Guard our going and coming to life and to peace evermore. Praised are you, Adonai, guardian of Israel, whose shelter of peace is spread over us, over all people of faith, over Jerusalem. Baruch atah Adonai, haporei sukkot shalom aleinu, ve'al kol amo Yisrael, ve'al Yerushalayim. We celebrate this Sabbath on page 162.
Thank you. In every city in which there are Jews, they are obligated to appoint of themselves tzedakah collectors, who are known to the community and trustworthy. These collectors would return to the community each week and collect from every person what they can give. They then distribute the monies, giving each poor person food that will last them a week. This is called the tzedakah fund.
Please rise. Amidah begins on page 164. Page 173. May these hours of rest and renewal open our hearts to joy and our minds to truth. May all who struggle find rest on this day. May all who suffer find solace. May all who hurt find healing on this day. And may all who despair find purpose. May all who hunger find fulfillment on this day. And may this day fulfill its promise. Baruch atah Adonai Mekadesh HaShabbat. Please be seated.
From the Talmud. When that great calamity came upon Job, he said to God, "Master of the universe, did I not feed the hungry and give drink to the thirsty? Did I not clothe the naked?" God replied, "Job, you have not reached even half the measure of Abraham. You sit and stay in your house, and the wayfarers come to you. To him who is accustomed to eat wheat bread, you give wheat bread to eat. To him who is accustomed to eat meat, you give meat to eat. To him who is accustomed to drink wine, you give wine to drink." But Abraham did not act in this way. Instead, he would go out everywhere, and when he found wayfarers, he brought them into his house. To him who was unaccustomed to eat wheat bread, he gave wheat bread to eat. To him who was unaccustomed to eat meat, he gave meat to eat. To him who was unaccustomed to drink wine, he gave wine to drink. More than that, he arose and built mansions on the highways and left food and drink there, and every passerby ate and drank and blessed heaven. That is why delight of spirit was given to him.
Nation shall not lift up sword against nation. We shall learn war no more. Page 179, Loisa Goy El Goy Cherev.
Loisa Goy Thank you.
As we think about the expanding grandeur of this world, that creation continues an ever-growing process, we pray that we take the responsibility to move that process in the direction of shleimut, of wholeness, to bringing ourselves into a better world with each other. Take a few moments, please, and let's pray for that strength and that focus to do this work. On the heels of our prayer for peace, we think about people who are in need of that sense of wholeness, restoring them to health, physically, emotionally, spiritually. People who around the world are suffering from the violence that we oppress each other with, the violence of nature, the people who are sick and ill and who are tired. People close to our homes, our families, we're thinking of Dorothy Parent, Honey Kibler, who's here and in good form, but you're going to stay in our prayers. And Gail Feldman, you're doing the same thing. You're on this list, but you're blessed. And we're blessed to hear Lois Galowitz, Nathan Snyder, Cantor Judith Avadia, and Ed Beck. And if there's other people we're holding in prayer, please share their names so that, you know, I don't know how it works. I do know that if we know, we find out that people are thinking about us and praying for us, the odds of us getting better than if they think that they're alone. So please share names that we can add. Baruch Ata Adonai Rofei HaCholim, God, please make us instruments of healing.
Korov,
So our floral display, there's a lot of food on the pulpit in front of me. Any guess how long that will feed a family? Week, maybe two at most. I've been part of congregations that during the high holidays have brought in 4,000 pounds of food. And people were very proud that we brought in literally 2 tons of food in a 4-week span. Until we went to fill the shelves of the pantry and then went back 3 weeks later to see the shelves empty. Hunger is insidious. And more people are doing without because more and more people are struggling. And people who live below the poverty line have to make choices. Do I feed my family? Do I pay rent? Do I get medical care? Do I provide education? And you get 2 of those 4 if you live at or below the poverty line. And what suffers is most always health care and food, and you end up getting whatever food you can get, which the cheap food is always the worst for you. So it's important that we remember, especially since the central tenet of everything Jewish is food, that we're obligated to make sure that people have what they need to thrive, not just to survive. And so it was just such an incredible blessing that when our social action committee got together and decided what the theme for social action Shabbat should be, that we talked about hunger insecurity. And so Sean Dorenzo, if you'd come on up, and I guess Ryan, you should come up because he's going to introduce you. There's a lot that we can learn beyond bringing food. And I pray that we not only pay attention, but that we commit to doing some of the things that we'll learn about.
Ryan Prater is the government relations manager at the Central Pennsylvania Food Bank. Prior to joining the food bank, Ryan spent time with a state government relations firm here in Harrisburg. A Montgomery County native, he first moved to Central PA to attend Susquehanna University, from where he graduated in 2019. Ryan currently lives in Harrisburg with his girlfriend and is an avid Philadelphia sports fan.
We won't hold it against.
Before we do him in, he's taking time out of his Friday night here to be our speaker. So here we go. Good luck.
Yeah, well, thank you, everybody, for having me tonight. It's a great opportunity. My title actually before I recently...
Just did. Into the microphone.
Little louder?
Yes, because we're working on a
there we go. All right. No, I said was thank you for the opportunity. Recently my title did change to Government Relations Manager. I was, before that, Community Engagement Coordinator. So my role a lot was to come out in the community, share what we're doing at the food bank. So really appreciate the opportunity today. I got started at the food bank in 2019. I had graduated college at Susquehanna, and I came to the food bank. It was in my faith, mostly in high school. When I was here in Susquehanna, I wasn't as engaged with my church, but I went on mission trips. So we were down in D.C., we went to New York twice, and I went to San Francisco. And a lot of that was about focused on hunger and the food, or hunger, food insecurity, the unhoused. So it really played a big part growing up, and I knew I wanted to get in the nonprofit world and knew the impact that nonprofits could have on their communities. So many people might be asking what the food bank is, or you know, you have an idea of what a food pantry, a food bank is. How I like to describe the food bank and Central Pennsylvania Food Bank is we're the wholesale distributor of charitable food for 27 counties in Central Pennsylvania. So we go from the New York border down to the Maryland border. We say it's about the size of New Jersey. It's about 1 million pounds of food a month, in those families. So we're the wholesale support that we collect all the food, like you might think a wholesale distributor, a giant might do. Then we have a network of over 1,200 partner agencies that are on the ground in every single community in Central Pennsylvania distributing that food. So we do it through a variety of means, which I will speak on in a moment. But we like to say that our impact is wide, but our impact is local, something like that. I'm blanking on the word, I'm sorry. But our impact is wide, but we really are a local in every single community. Partners here in Harrisburg include, the Salvation Army of Harrisburg, Ecumenical Food Pantry, really any food pantry. Most of them are partnering with the food bank to receive their food, all free of charge, except small service fees to transport the food, but completely free of charge to our partners and ultimately the people who need it. We receive food through a variety of means. We mostly USDA, the Department of Agriculture. Again, that's a government program that brings in that food from the Department of Agriculture. They purchase it from farmers across the country. We also do a lot of retail donations. So we partner with Giant, Wise, Walmarts, Dollar Generals, and rescue their leftover product, right? It's not product that's bad, but it's product that might be getting close to the end of its shelf life. It might be a product that is, needs to just make space for the next round of product. The uglies is what the agriculture industry calls it, right? The product that looks ugly and someone might not pick up at the grocery store, or the bananas that are a little browned, that perfectly edible, perfectly nutritious, but might not be the best. It might not be selling in the store. So we rescue those products and work that in. And those are the hardest to find is the healthy, fresh produce, vegetables, fresh meat. We have a very good partnership with Giant where we rescue the meat that, again, it is not bad. It's just nearing the end of its shelf life, and we can get it to people who need it, within a couple days before it goes bad. So as I mentioned, we have a variety of partners, all different shapes and sizes and methods to delivering. We have our typical food pantries. I know I mentioned Ecumenical Food Pantry downtown is one I always think of, where they are simply a food pantry, right? You come in, you might make an appointment, and you go around. And most of them now, we focus on choice, giving people choice in their options. So it's like a grocery store. That's what we strive to do, is provide a grocery-like experience where you can come in and walk through, shelves of food, and you start with your breads, and you move down into your meats and your fresh fruits and vegetables. I really appreciate the rabbi starting with a focus on the people and keeping the people in mind. That's something we always try to do at the food bank, that these are people just like us. These are our neighbors. And they deserve the same respect and dignity that everybody else does. So offering these charitable food in a dignified way is so important to us. So making it just like a grocery store is really key in what we strive to do with all our pantries. We work with other larger partners. I said the Salvation Army. I think of New Hope Ministries is really big over in Cumberland in New York County, where they are, I'd say, more social service organizations. So they offer a lot of what we call wraparound services. So they might offer shelters or shelters themselves, right, we partner with. They offer financial literacy. They offer all sorts of different services, job training, transportation to and from jobs, really giving that all-encompassing experience. And that's what we know people need to thrive, right? We're not just trying to look to make them survive, even though in the short term that is the goal. We want people to thrive. We want all of our communities to thrive. So, you know, everything we can do to get people back on their feet, right? If that's getting a ride to work, that's just as important as having the food in your belly. We have a variety of youth programs. So we work, right, the schools as best we can with the school breakfast program, the school lunch program, but after school programs, programs in the summer. Youth hunger goes up a lot in the summer when there's not the school meals. So we sponsor summer sites at camps and parks where students can come and get, again, in the summer, breakfast and lunch. We have senior programs. There's a federal program that is for seniors. We also have another program that is for other seniors who don't quite qualify for some of those other programs. Health innovations, where we work as food as medicine. I think that's one that resonates a lot with people, is we know what we eat, right, influences lots of things from very young development to how we feel, right, as adults. So integrating that method and that idea into all of our services, where we offer nutritious food. We have a food ranking guide that we encourage partners to receive from us, sign up to receive, the healthier products. And we say you should buy this, get this a lot more than you get the chips and the soda. Partnerships in the health realm, including with the hospitals, healthcare providers, managed care organizations, to do, again, food as medicine, right, for people with diabetes or hypertension, high blood pressure, and offering them better options. And then one last thing that I would be remiss in not speaking on, especially in my role as government relations manager, would be SNAP, the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program. SNAP, short, right, an acronym, provides 9 meals for every 1 that the charitable food system does. So that means that our collection of the food banks, and we are one of 9 Feeding America food banks in Pennsylvania that we all have, our different regions, and our network of statewide 3,000 partner agencies, we still would not be able to keep up with the demand. It's a 9-to-1 ratio. So advocating and talking about these programs like SNAP are so critical, because we could not do it without these programs. We also have a very intense data team that is relatively new, the research and data team, that is going into our communities, and we're calling it hunger mapping. And we're actually starting in Dauphin County soon, where we're trying to make more informed decisions about how we spend our dollars, how we allocate programs and resources, to really find pockets where there is need. We first did this down in York County, and we found that, right, some areas there were a lot of food pantries and there was a lot of food, and that was really awesome. But there were really rural parts, right, usually rural parts of the community, and York County in particular, that there was one food pantry open on a Tuesday afternoon from 2 to 4 o'clock. And that's not going to be suitable for a single mom working, right? It's not going to be good for a family who has to pick up, their kids are at school and has to work till 5 and pick up their kids after school. So really taking a look at that, and we plan to do that in all 27 counties, a big undertaking, but it will really help us make better informed decisions at the food bank and hopefully really do a better job at addressing food insecurity in our communities. So I'll wrap up here with how to get involved. I have a slick little saying that, rhymes, donate, participate, advocate. So obviously donate your treasure, your time, however, you most feel comfortable. That's pretty straightforward. I don't speak too much on that. It's straightforward. And if you're available, we always would welcome that and appreciate that so much. But participate, right? Volunteer. Come volunteer at the food bank. We have our facility here in Harrisburg where you can sign up for shifts Monday through Friday, even Saturday mornings, to help pack boxes, right? So I said we strive to have a grocery store-like experience, but sometimes that's not feasible. Sometimes you have to do a drive-through distribution. Some of these other programs, a lot of our senior programs, we just provide a pre-packed box. So you can help us pack boxes right here at our CPO in Harrisburg. You can also find a local pantry in your community that needs volunteers, right? They need it just as much as we do at the food bank. And then finally, advocate, and that's my specialty, so I will speak the most on that. And, you know, of course, if you have any questions, I'll be out here afterwards to answer any questions you might have, and I have a little bit more information about everything I've talked about. But advocate, like I said, a lot of these programs that we use, they're private-public partnerships with, you know, federal government, with the state government. It's a farm bill year. Many people think the farm bill is for farms, which it generally is, but actually nutrition programs like SNAP, like the USDA program that brings food to the food banks, like the senior programs, those are all funded through the farm bill. So it's critically important that we make our voice heard. You know, here in Harrisburg would be Congressman Scott Perry, Senators Casey, Fetterman. You know, regardless of your political leanings, and that's, we stay very nonpartisan, right? It's, we find it critical to make our voice heard, share our mission, and let them know what we, you know, what they can do better to serve the people in our community. And then I'd say also, we also have state budget priorities, right, that also come in and you can advocate for, that help us get food to the food bank and ultimately to people in need. So there's all sorts of opportunities, even just raising your voice, posting something on social media, participate, advocate, raising awareness about the food bank and our mission is so critical, just like this opportunity tonight. So I'm very appreciative of your time tonight and for listening. I will be out right out here afterwards to answer any questions. Like I said, a little bit more information about some of these programs, but really thankful for your interest. And yeah, thanks for having me.
You glossed over something that is so crucial, and I know it's an important piece. I need everyone at some point to look up lunch break in Red Bank, New Jersey, which started off as a regional food pantry, but through its partnerships provided the wraparound and the 360. Because providing food is an act of charity. Solving hunger, it's tzedakah. Tzedakah is not the charitable act. We too often mistake and use those terms as synonymous, but tzedakah is solution. And so while we're finding ways to help people find homes and to educate, to job train, to life skill train, which will be involved here as well as partners, the ability to be able to eat while you're doing that is crucial. Mm-hmm. But prophetically, to be able to partner with the organizations, as you mentioned, that providing these other services, because if someone's coming, they're hungry, they're also lacking medical services, and they're also lacking in their, and that's, I think, even beyond the participation in the packing or the volunteering at a pantry, the bringing of food or the dollars that we can donate, getting involved in some of these partner organizations that can help us change lives and change the trajectory of lives is what it's going to take to solve this problem moving forward. So we got a lot of work that I think we're going to be doing together.
We do, yeah. And okay. I look forward to it. Hey, and I remember after, right, I have a second to compose myself. That line from the beginning is, our mission is wide, our impact is local.
So. Got it.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Ryan.
Yeah, thank you.
So the reason I ask you to look up lunch break, not now, and services, okay? It started as a food pantry in Red Bank, and through years of growth, advocacy, and partnership, it's now the 360 organization. And when you go there, every facet of need is being taken care of within the walls. And it's becoming a paradigm for organizations around the country that are doing exactly what Ryan was talking about, creating the relationships so that we can holistically take care of everybody who walks through our front door or who we can bring into our front doors. With that, we're going to rise. We're on page 486. Ushlinatu zo bigov he meroni, hu Eloheinu v'anahu korim, u'mishtachavim u'modim, lifnei me'ach ma'ach ve'amachim.
the ultimate gift of Thanksgiving, we recall those who have paved the road that we can walk, who have built and maintained the house of worship in which we pray, the facilities in the areas that sustain our lives, and in calling them to mind and memory, we also commit to continuing to grow the legacy that they've left to us. This week's Yahrzeits, Louis Astrakhan, Danya Lynn Babinski, James Brody, Benjamin Cantor, Hyman Cohen, Louis W. Cohen, Sarah Cooper, Ruth Fendel, Samuel Joseph Finkel, Warren Gitten, Leon Grobman, Arthur H. Goldberg, Philip H. Goldberg, Francis Goodman, Albert Hirschler, Martha Hurwitz, May Husick, David Kaufman, Joseph Kaufman, Charles Kibler, Sam Klotzman, Jenny Feller Limbeck, Bernard Lehrman, Judith Margolis, Dorothy Rosenbaum, Morris Samet, Tilly Scheinwald, Bell O. Stern, Joshua Strauss, Benjamin Strauss, Harry A. Wagenheim, Mrs. Shirley Walker, Rosalie Wolfe, and Norman Yaffe. Are there other annual Yahrzeits being observed this week? Zichronam Livracha, may the memories that they leave us lead us to blessing. Page 598, we join in the words sanctifying their memories. Yitgadal v'yitgadash shemei rabba, be'alma divrach hirute v'yamlich malchute, b'chai yechon av yom echon, uv'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael, b'agala v'izman kari v'imru, amen. Yehe shemei rabba mevorach le'olam ulamei almaya, yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnase, v'yit adar v'yit ale v'yitalal shemei d'kudsha b'richu, Leila min kol birchata v'shirata, tushpechata v'nechemata, ta'amiran be'alma v'imru, amen. Yehe shlomo rabba min shmaya, v'chaim aleinu ve'al ko Yisrael v'imru, amen. Osei shalom b'imromav, hu yaase shalom aleinu ve'al ko Yisrael v'imru, amen. May the source of peace send it to all of us, to all who are bereaved and all who are in need. And may we say, amen. Please be seated.
It's announcements time. Social Action Committee. Hey, you all get to help me read. Hi. So I have this nice sheet here if anyone else would like to read. Line up. Okay, welcome from the Social Action Committee for Ohev Shalom. For those who are here tonight and those who are not present, we, like you, are dedicated to Tikkun Olam and building ways to help repair the world and our community together as a team. We have plans that are great and small and are excited to build on the amazing work this temple accomplishes every day.
To help organize our actions, work, and initiatives, the Social Action Committee has developed the idea of having monthly or bi-monthly focus themes on issues faced by many or all of us in our community. April's theme is feeding, in honor of Passover, and as a good time to focus on the food insecurity issues that impact so many in our community and beyond, and what we can do to help.
You hopefully have noticed the display of food up front here instead of the flowers normally placed in front of the bima. This is to draw attention to some of the basic things we can help provide to our community and inspire you to donate to our April food drive to be donated to JFS and Ukrainian refugees. Boxes for donations are by both entrances to the temple, and we are happy for any contributions you can provide.
However, as we know, we must provide more than just food donations for a stronger future as a community that's dedicated to uplifting everyone. That is why we want to deeply thank Ryan from the Central Pennsylvania Food Bank for being here tonight to shed light on the current issues in Pennsylvania specifically. The information Ryan provided is invaluable and inspired each of us to do more. Please feel free to catch Ryan for more literature and information in the back after service, and thank him for spending his time with us. There's a lot more that we can do in addition to bringing food.
Meanwhile, hopefully you all are feeling inspired and will be looking for ways, big and small, to get involved with the work of this committee. Information about the work the Social Action Committee is starting up and getting involved in can be found under the Social Action page on the Temple's website. There, you can find a calendar of events, our virtual meeting times, and volunteer opportunities. You can also sign up for email communications if you even just want to be in the loop about what we're up to or have ideas as to what you would like the Temple to be involved in.
Thanks to Rabbi Conrad and Lori for and Andrea for tonight's special service and all of the music involved to inspire. May's theme will be about community as we invite Capital Rebirth into our community to utilize many of the unused classrooms and space in our lovely building. Stay tuned for more information from the Social Action Committee on May and the coming months and involvement opportunities. We're excited to work alongside so many of you to make a positive impact in our community and beyond.
Oh, now the rest of the bulletin. All right, thanks for listening to that. Now we get to, if you didn't have a turn, you still have a chance. Because there's a lot more going on in this temple, which is awesome. So virtual Torah study, Saturday 15th at 9 a.m. Text for the week is Leviticus 9:12 through 10:11, Alien Fire at the Altar, Sin or Prophecy. It's Becca's favorite thing. You should attend. There's a Zoom link present in here if you would like to check it out. Does anyone else want to read? Dates to remember. Tuesdays at Elementary Coffee, we will gather. We will gather at this lovely joint called Elementary Coffee, 256 North Street, at Tuesday mornings at 9. There's no agenda. It's just very good coffee and a safe place to talk and about anything. Bring friends. It's open to anybody. A social action food drive, which is ongoing, that we've talked about today all April, is there's a list of food in there that you can check out that we are looking to collect, and we will donate to JFS at the end of the month. From all teens on April 16th, Sunday. That's on Sunday, from 10 to 11:30, 10th grade. 10 until 12:30, the Holocaust in America, anti-Semitism, ignorance, and how to not be part of the problem, then preparing for confirmation. It's heavy. New member Shabbat, Friday, April 21st. Join us to welcome new families. Become a new family and enjoy our worship, 6 p.m., and a very special Oneg Shabbat, dessert, and fellowship following. Temple Ohev Shalom Book Club, April 23rd, Part 2, all are welcome. The book for March is Azer Nafisi's book, Reading Lolita in Tehran, and there's more information in your bulletin. And an email if you would like to participate. June 16th, Shabbat with the Senators, services in the ballpark, followed by watching the game together in the stands. This is also, June 17th. Okay, details in the flyers around the building and our weekly email on our website and in the newsletter. Does anyone else want to read? This is a lot.
This one, okay. Oh, this is a good one.
There we go.
Sisterhood Donor Dinner. I'm very excited about that. Coming up April 27th at 7 p.m. For those who donated to our special Sisterhood campaign, watch your email for your invitation to join us for a special catered dinner to be held in the social hall. Payment for the meal can be paid at the door. For those who still want to donate, please send, please contact Denise Miskin or send a check to Denise Miskin as well. Her email and address is in the program. Please remember this is a dinner this dinner is for only those who have donated to this annual donor campaign. So still time to get your donations in to join us. Are you interested in Are you interested in participating, like us, in these weekly Friday night Shabbat services or Saturday B'nai Mitzvah services? We're looking for volunteers to usher, light the candles, and someone to read announcements. Look, anyone can do it. Please contact Dan Green, that's how I got my in, for more information. You can also show up before services and let Rabbi Mark know that you want to participate. Again, everyone is welcome. The Temple Gift Shop is open Sunday mornings from 9 until noon. Please contact Miriam Robinson for more information. And then please check out our website for the Ohev Shalom newsletter for a lot more information and details on the announcements that we shared.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, our Social Action Committee. Okay, we're going to close tonight. The words are also both in Hebrew transliteration and in an English translation. Anivata, Eric Einstein and Miki Gavrielov wrote this piece as a way of reminding us that the world doesn't change if we don't do it, that God doesn't solve hunger. We partner with God to do that work, and that if there's needs, God can't do what we won't participate in doing. So ani ve'ata neshane et ha'olam, you and I, we can change the world.
Ani ve'ata neshane et ha'olam. Ani ve'ata az yavo. Amru etzet kodem lefana velo neshane. Ani ve'ata neshane et ha'olam. Ani ve'ata nenase mechad kala. Yenora en devar. Amru etzet kodem lefana velo neshane. Ani ve'ata neshane et ha'olam. Ani ve'ata neshane et ha'olam.
For the blessings that we share along life's path, we give thanks for the opportunities to grow ourselves, our community, and our relationships with the world. We ask God to give us strength. And for all of the things for which we take for granted, but which feed our lives and give it value, we ask God to help us pay more attention. And so with that, I'm going to go down there. We have a new container. Bread will not fall off the basket. Everyone say thank you, John. Okay. We will conclude our service. We will thank Andrea and Lori and Conrad for music tonight. And Scott for being up there in the balcony running the live stream. And for everyone who's participating and who's leading us. Ryan, please come back and join us at all times. Cynthia, God, you're with us. We have a new friend, pastor, who's doing some research with us tonight. And for those who are prepared, we're going to go downstairs afterwards for soup and study. Reverend Earl Harris is here in the back, and he and I are going to reprise a conversation that we had at the Grass Center on MLK Day on Are Jews White? So it should be provocative with my dear friends. So with that, anybody that wants to consider themselves young and join Motzi, meet me at the bottom.